This is the 2005 Sea Ray 340 Sundancer. Just wanted to give you a shot with the covers on. You'll see it has the windshield cover. Now there is a small tear in it by the snaps on that, but it absolutely does its function, and this owner just didn't care about that little tear. But someone can either use it as it is, or they can use it as pattern to get a new one made. And then you'll see here the aft sunshade, but it also has a cover underneath the aft sunshade, and there's a shot of the covers. Stepping aboard, that'll give us a good shot of this very large swim platform, and you'll see storage there in the center. And then walking through to the cockpit, if I open up here, you're gonna see your hot and cold shower. And then walking through into the cockpit, let's just give you a look around. And that brings us to this U-shaped seating, and you'll see just a ton of room to bring all your friends and family. You'll see a table there in the center, and then underneath all this seating, you're gonna have storage. And then if I go ahead and I turn around, that's gonna bring you to the wet bar. And there you'll see drink holders, a nice size sink. And if I open up down below, you're gonna see your refrigerator. And then directly adjacent to that, you're gonna see storage. And then above that, you're gonna see your first mate seat. And your first mate seat has a bolster. And now that will bring us up to our helm area, and you'll see you have room for plus one with the captain, and both those seats are outfitted with bolsters. And then if I go ahead and I turn forward, that will bring us to our actual helm. And let's start here at the top of the helm with this Ritchie compass. And below that, you're gonna see the gauges. And then you can see the stars of the show, which are these twin HDS-9Ms. And this boat is just fully loaded. It's got radar, GPS, depth, of course. It's also got the autopilot, and then it's got the really cool technology, the AIS system, which is about vessel identification. That's a really neat system to learn about, but it's just a really loaded Sea Ray Sundancer. Then on the sides of those displays, you're going to see all your switches, and then down below, you're going to see your VHF and stereo controls. And that will bring us down into our cabin. You'll see a very roomy master berth, and then if you look on each side, you're going to see cabinets for storage. Over here you have cabinets, then on this side you have three cabinets, and then come over here and open this up and you're going to see a very large hanging locker. And that brings us over to the port side, where you'll see a privacy curtain, so you can pull that over and give the master privacy. And then if I go ahead and I turn around, you'll see a very large sofa in the center with a table. Of course, that adds an additional berth. And then you'll see storage cabinets all the way across on the wall above. Now if I turn to the port side, you're going to see a very large galley. And if I go ahead, start up here, you've got a microwave and coffee maker, storage below. Over here you're going to see a TV with stereo controls, and storage below as well. Very large counter space. Then if I lift up here, you're going to see a two burner stove. And just forward of that, lift up here and you've got a large sink. Then below the counter, you're going to see a large refrigerator, drawer storage, and cupboard storage. And that brings us all the way aft to the mid cabin. You'll see just another roomy area for additional seating. And this all curtains off for a private double berth in the mid cabin. And plus you'll see just a lot of room and also storage on both ends. And then if I go ahead and I just turn to the side here and I open up here, you're gonna see there's your panel, and it's clearly labeled, very organized. open up here and you'll see a very roomy head. You'll see storage above and below, as well as a shower. And let's go ahead and lift up this electric hatch and give you guys a shot of the engine space. And here's a good shot of these Twin Merc Cruiser 8.1 Horizons. Now, these motors have 625 hours on them. And over on the starboard side, you're gonna see the Kohler generator. It's got like, I think it's 120 hours on it, very low hour generator. But if you just look at this engine room, you'll just see very neat, clean, organized engine room. And now's the time of the video where I give a condition report and name opportunities for the new owner to improve this boat. And looking around this 2005 Sea Ray 340 Sundancer, you'll see this owner, you can tell, really cared for the boat. He's always serviced it with certified mercury, and it's outfitted just the way that people would like. It's got a very nice electronics package. I don't think it wants for anything. And an aft sunshade. It has all the covers. It's got eyes and glass. If you come down here, everything seems to show well in the interior. He just seems to have taken good care of it. He's owned it 8 years. He's the second owner. And looking around, I think you can use this video to set your expectations, and I think it shows very well for a 2005 Sea Ray 340 Sundancer. In terms of opportunities for the new owner to improve this boat, I know he mentioned that the choke sometimes sticks on the generator, so starting it from the cabin sometimes doesn't work out, and you have to go down into the engine space and just hit the generator directly, but it only happens sometimes. I would look around. I'd say the eyes and glass, I mean, is very usable. It's fine. But I think the next owner in the, you know, semi-near future is going to probably want to address that. There is covers on the windshield cover, as well as an aft cover. They're worn. They're doing their job. But if somebody wanted to, they could replace those covers with some new covers. And it seems to have the cruising package a lot of people would like and is ready for some summer fun.